boosting brains and banishing toxins. Could B12 shots be the game changer for kids with autism? Can a simple injection make a difference in speech, behavior, and overall health? Hi, I'm Dr. Theresa Lyons, Yale University trained scientist and autism parent. And I teach parents the cutting edge science of autism so that you can make the best decisions for your child based on quality information. Today, we're diving deep into the world of vitamin B12 shots for kids with autism. What are the benefits, the risks, the real science behind them? Let's get started. First, let's talk about vitamin B12. Vitamin B12 is a critical nutrient for the nervous system. It plays a key role in myelin synthesis, which helps protect nerve fibers, nerve metabolism, and neuronal regeneration. Think of vitamin B12 as a super fuel that powers nerve function, especially in the brain. But it doesn't stop there. Vitamin B12 is also involved in detoxification process. It helps reduce oxidative stress, which can affect brain function and overall health. So why are B12 shots gaining popularity for kids with autism? Let's get to the research. Research shows that many children with autism have low levels of B12, which can lead to neurological and behavioral challenges. Why does this happen? Well, picky eating is common in children with autism, and that can severely impact nutrition. So some kids might not be eating enough food rich in B12, or they also might be eating the foods but have trouble absorbing it due to digestive issues in their gut. And we know gut health is important in overall health. B12 injections are a quick way to boost vitamin B12 levels because when injected, it goes directly into the bloodstream, bypassing any absorption problems in the gut. Does your child really need B12 shots? Make sure to get the right lab tests to see if your child truly needs them. B12 shots aren't fun to give, right? It's a shot. Doesn't sound too fun. So it's really important to make sure they're necessary. If you're going to go through that stress, make sure you actually need to do it. So how does B12 work in the body to support children with autism? One of the most important functions of vitamin B12 is activating the methylation pathway. Now, the methylation pathway is a critical biochemical process that affects DNA synthesis, neurotransmitter production, brain function, and detoxification. Many kids with autism have methylation issues, which vitamin B12 can help address. Vitamin B12 also plays a critical role in detoxification by maintaining glutathione levels. Glutathione is a powerful antioxidant that prevents cells from damage. Think oxidative stress. I go over this a lot in a video I have on detox. So when glutathione is deficient, B12's metabolic functions can actually be impaired, potentially leading to more oxidative stress. So by supporting both methylation and glutathione, B12 may help reduce some autism symptoms by impacting those areas of health. What are the potential benefits of B12 shots? Studies have shown that B12 injections can lead to improvement in behavioral and cognitive function. There is published science on that. Parents often report their kids becoming more energetic, more focused, and socially engaged. Some even notice better communication skills and reduced anxiety. Some parents see their children start to speak more and more. Not everyone, some parents. Remember that every child is different. While some show significant improvement with B12 shots, others might not respond as strongly or even at all. B12 is not a cure-all, but it can be a valuable part of a comprehensive approach to managing autism and shooting for optimal outcome. Now let's talk about safety and administration. So B12 injections are generally considered safe for kids. They're not suitable for everyone. Again, do the lab tests first to make sure you actually need them. Some children might experience mild side effects like redness or discomfort at the injection site. Some children will do better if you just put a little numbing cream 30 minutes before you do the injection. And many parents do these injections at night. Others might not tolerate B12 well if they have certain underlying health issues. So again, doing appropriate lab tests are important before giving B12 shots. No matter what a doctor might say, do those tests. Who shouldn't get B12 shots? It's essential to consult with a healthcare provider who can assess your child's specific needs and determine if B12 shots are right for them. Also, before starting B12 therapy, make sure to perform the lab test to check B12 levels both in the blood and in the cells. It's really important to understand, do they have enough B12 and it can't get into the cell to be used, or do they not have enough B12? There's a difference. In general, any child with yeast issues or hyperactivity usually are not a good fit for B12 shots at that time. Remember, at that time. That doesn't mean forever. The important and tricky thing with autism is to give the right treatment at the right time. Unfortunately, some parents, they give B12 shots too early in the process, and then they have a terrible experience. It definitely can happen. Not because B12 is bad, but because it wasn't given at the right time for that child. You have to be an informed parent and working with a knowledgeable healthcare provider who recommends doing the appropriate lab tests first. This will give a clearer picture of whether there's a deficiency and if your child's body is utilizing B12 effectively. Remember, B12 injections are by prescription only in the US, so you must work with a knowledgeable doctor to get the correct dosage. Let's address some common concerns. One question I hear a lot is, why do I feel worse after a B12 injection? So typically, when someone is deficient in B12 and they get a B12 shot, they feel great. It's like life-changing. And then you start to see it wear off, the wearing off effect. So the typical response of a B12 shot for someone who needs it is that they feel great, it wears off, and they're back to their previous baseline. This is when dosing and frequency is adjusted. If you feel worse after a B12 shot, then typically it was not appropriate to give as the body didn't need it or the initial dose was too high. Again, this is why you want to use lab tests to guide your decision. And please always communicate with your healthcare provider if you notice any adverse effects. On TikTok, we often hear B12 shots are a miracle cure for autism. That is a myth. Be careful about what you hear on TikTok. Oh, I go on there and I really cringe. The science there is just clickbait. So please, it is a myth that B12 shots are a miracle cure for autism. While B12 can help some children by addressing specific biochemical needs, it is not a universal solution. It is all about finding what works best for your child. Thinking about trying B12 shots, here are a few steps to take. First, consult with a healthcare provider who understands autism and B12 therapy. Next, get the necessary lab tests to measure B12 levels, both inside and outside of the cell. Once you start, monitor your child's progress closely and be prepared to adjust the dose. Be prepared to adjust the frequency. That's why you want to observe, how are things going? Did you see things wear off? That's how you increase the frequency. Sometimes you also increase the dose. It's important to be observant and to notice these things. Confused by all the information out there about autism? I've got you. Click the link below to see how we can work together. Let me break down the science and provide you with clear, actionable steps to make your path forward easy. Have you tried B12 shots for your child? What changes have you noticed? Share the experience in the comments below. Your story could help another family going through the same journey. Thank you for watching, and remember, knowledge is power. Stay informed, stay empowered, and keep making the best decisions for your child. See you in the next video.